Despite widespread outcry, drug prices continue to rise. David Ridley, an economist at Duke University's Fuqua School of Business, and C.Y. Lee, a Duke alumnus, believe part of the problem is the way Medicare reimburses healthcare providers for drugs. When medical providers administer a drug to a Medicare patient, Medicare repays the provider based on the average past price of the drug. If the drug cost more in the past, the provider is paid more. So most providers don't have a reason to care whether the drug costs $1 or $1,000 because they'll be paid back either way. And they get more money today if the price in the past was higher. This is not unique to Medicare because private insurers follow their lead. Knowing how reimbursement works, manufacturers set high launch prices. This system is bad for patients who often pay 20% of the price, and it's bad for taxpayers who pay for Medicare-funded reimbursements. High prices are good for drug companies and encourage firms to invest in drug development, but prices that aren't set by the market can lead to lopsided investment. The current system replaced another flawed system, so going back won't fix it. The researchers propose tying the price of a drug to its value, as measured by the quality of life it provides, or how long it can extend life. The British do something similar. Reducing reimbursements would make providers nervous, but Ridley predicts drug prices would fall for drugs providing little value. These value-based payments would mean lower co-payments, lower premiums, and maybe even lower taxes.